Good evening. Appreciate everybody coming out tonight. We have a small crowd, which I think is indicative of the fact that y'all are good candidates, and we're pleased to have all of our candidates here who are running in uncontested races. Obviously, the folks at Forsyth County thought these candidates were doing a good job in office, and we're glad that you're here and appreciate you taking time to come and speak to us. We do have some folks in the audience who are videotaping us, so I'm sure this will be shown on the internet. So I hope that all the candidates who are here will take a few minutes and introduce themselves, tell us what you feel like you've accomplished in office, and what your plans are for the next 4 years in your term. As always, I would always like to start our Republican Party meetings with an invocation and our Pledge of Allegiance. If y'all would please stand as you're able. Lord, thank you for our country and our county and the ability to elect people from our community to serve us in public office. We pray that you be with those who are seeking office, who are serving us in office. And we pray that you provide them safety and wisdom. Be with our community. Help us to grow. Help us to look out for others' needs. And forgive our sins. In Christ's name, amen.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Welcome. For those of you that don't know me, my name is Ethan Underwood. I have the opportunity to serve as chairman of the Forsyth County Republican Party. And this is our debate series for 2012. We're pleased that folks are participating. Tonight is, as we said, a forum for candidates who are running in uncontested. You are the Republican nominee. You're carrying the banner for the Republican Party. So we appreciate you throwing your hat in the ring and being willing to serve. Too often what you do goes unrewarded, and we appreciate your time away from your family and from your businesses to serve our community. We have, five candidates here tonight. I believe we're four candidates, at least four. Our fifth one is still on the way. But if we could, we'll go ladies first. We have with us Nancy Roche, who is the Republican nominee for District 5 School Board. Nancy is completing her second term in office. This will be this will be your fourth that you're going for. So she's certainly very experienced, and we're glad that you were joining us. So Nancy, if you would please tell us what your intent and your goals are in office this year.
Okay.
Thank you. Let's see.
Hopefully that'll pick up. Thank you, Ethan. I appreciate it. I appreciate the Republican Party sponsoring the debate series this year. And I am the incumbent, and I'm very, very pleased, as well as for Tom and for Darla, that we are running unopposed. I think that tells us a lot about our community. I think they're happy with our school system. I think they have the confidence in us that we will continue to do a good job for the citizens of Forsyth County. Right now, we have the lowest millage rate in the Atlanta area and the highest test scores. I think, thank you. I appreciate that. I really do. I think it's a real good return on your investment for coming to Forsyth County and educating your children. And families still do want to move here. We're growing an average of 1,300 kids a year. A lot of people don't think we're growing at all. Everybody says, no, we're stagnant. I said, no, and that's about an elementary school every single year. And unfortunately, we don't have the money to keep building them. We do have one opening this fall, but after that, we don't have the money to build any more schools right now. When I was on the board in 2001, there were about 15,000 students, and we're expecting over 38,000 this fall. We had 17 schools back in 2001, and now we'll be opening number 36 this fall. Again, we have more than doubled in the past 12 years since I started on the Board of Education. The millage rate was at 15.5, and today it's only at 16.3. To me, I think that's a very, very great accomplishment for us, because I think we've just been really frugal with the taxpayers' money and really looked at every single program and said, what do we need to keep and what do we need to get rid of and how do we do better with the taxpayers' money. It really is an accomplishment because since 2003, the state started austerity cuts and they have cut over $100 million from us. And it's money that we have earned through our QBE formula, but they just have not passed it along to us. In fact, this year alone, $21.9 million is our austerity cut, which is almost $800,000 more than last year. So again, the austerity cuts have not gone away. Also, our local revenue has decreased. Unfortunately, in the last 4 years, almost, 16.56%. We just got the local digest today, and since last year, it's down 3.88%. Again, that's another $1.1 million. We were counting on it being 3%, and it's 3.88, so it's another $1.1 million that we have to take out of reserves. We're planning to approve the budget this coming Thursday, and we do not plan on raising the millage rate again this year. That's been our biggest challenge. How do we educate the student of tomorrow as the state and local funding continue to decline? In Forsyth County, we've been very innovative. We've done such programs as IE Squared. That's investing in educational excellence, and it gives us a lot of money, a lot of flexibility on how we spend the money. If you're not under IE Squared, the state tells you exactly where you need to spend the money. And you may not need money for special education in certain parts of the county, but you may need extra money in other parts of the county. With IE Squared, we can go school by school. Each principal can decide what's the best use for the money in their school. So it really has helped us use our money more effectively and efficiently. We also started the BYOT program. That's bring your own technology. And if you bring your own technology, that means the taxpayers are not buying it and they're not having to maintain those devices. The kids love it because most of the time they have that device in their pocket anyway and they want to use it. So if you haven't seen that in any of our schools, please go. There's even kindergarten classes that are bringing technology. And if you don't have the technology, if there's some families do not, we have it available in the school, so nobody is ever left out. Managing these challenges, we feel, has come down to effective leadership. We've worked very hard in Forsyth County to develop great leaders, from the central office to the schools and to each and every classroom. We know that the quality of the teacher in the classroom is the most valuable asset that we have in Forsyth County. No one has received a raise in the last 4 years, but we just advertised our budget and we plan on giving everyone in the school system a 1% raise this year. We just, I get emotional about it, but we just really feel that it's something we need to do. And we hopefully they will appreciate it, and hopefully things will really start getting better in the next few years, and we can do even more in the next few years. We must continue working with our legislators very closely to make them understand that adequate funding from the state is vital to our maintaining the quality of our school system and a prosperous Georgia. We're also just beginning a new strategic plan for 2013 to 2016 called Our Path to Greatness. And we hope that the community will provide us with many new insights and new ideas for the Forsyth County schools. It'll be happening this fall. We'll be going out to the community, again, getting input. That's the way our strategic plans have been since we started back in 1995. And I think that's why we've been so successful in Forsyth County, because we have the community support. So we hope that we get all those new ideas and we continue to thrive in Forsyth County. And I look forward to keeping us on that path to greatness. And hopefully the people are confident in the fact that all of us have been a big part of that. And again, I'm very, very happy that we have no opposition and that we continue to grow and thrive in Forsyth County. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Ms. Roche. Next, we'll introduce Commissioner Matthew Ledbetter. He is our tax commissioner, and no one ever likes to go and pay taxes, but I think he's done a very, very good job of creating an atmosphere where it's quick customer response, good results, and it's a very helpful place to be. I think he's done a great job, and I'd like to introduce Commissioner Matthew Ledbetter.
Thank you. I would like to thank the Republican Party also for having out the candidates tonight. And we're glad that we're unopposed this year. We're tickled with that. I drive down the road and I see a lot of effort going into these campaigns and things, and we're glad that we're not having to do that much work this year. We're glad of that. Out at the Tax Commissioner's office, we'll be as short and sweet as we know how to be. We sold 237,000 car tags last year. That's up 6.5%. So like Ann was saying, we are still growing. I mean, Nancy, I'm sorry, Nancy. We are still growing, and we are doing this. 4 years ago, we had 42 employees at the Tax Commissioner's office. We now have 31. We have just opened a drive-through window for customer service. We're a big believer in customer service. We like to greet people at the door, treat them with respect, and get your business done in a timely manner while you're at the Tax Commissioner's office. It's just been a long road to get the customer service to where it is now, and we want to continue to go forward. And as technology changes, I think you'll see a lot of change over the next 4 years with when they make the change in your car tags to a $30 standard sticker. It's going to change the technology a lot. It's going to make it a lot more convenient for the customers, which is the taxpayers for South County, and it's going to make it a little bit tough on us to get all those people acquainted with how the new rules and laws are going to work. But we're going to do our best to do that. And we went down last month to get trained at Athens on the new car tags, and I know I'm going to get a lot of questions on that, but they told us to hold off. We're going to have a cleanup bill coming in February, so we'll see how that's all going to work. I understand it one way, and I think it's going to change a little bit, so I'd rather not even go into the way it's going to work, because I don't want to give anybody bad information. We answer the phone live out of the Tax Commissioner's office. As far as I know, we're the only office in the county that answers the phone live except for 911. I believe when you dial a number in this county and you pay these employees that you should be treated with customer service. I think you want to talk to somebody. You're not calling up there to shoot the breeze. You got a question about taxes and we want to get it answered and get you taken care of. We're taking credit cards out there at the office now. We do debit cards, checks, cash always. And we're just looking every day at different ways that we could be more convenient to the taxpayers. You know, I don't really set a lot of policies. I just do the laws that the state of Georgia governs me to do. And you know, we want to make that as convenient as we can, as painless as possible. If anybody ever has any problem with their taxes in Forsyth County, let me know. I'll be more than glad to help you any way I can. I'm there every day. Just come see me or give me a call. And thank y'all for having me.
Next, I will introduce our award-winning clerk of court. He actually won an award for being the finest clerk of court in the 9th District. So I'd like now to introduce Mr. Greg Allen.
Hello, sir. Thank you, Andrew. Thank you for the kind words. I greatly appreciate that. I want to thank the citizens and voters of Forsyth County for electing me clerk of courts in 2008. And for having the confidence to allow me to continue to serve another term as your clerk of Superior State Courts. It's said that time flies when you're having fun, and the last 4 years have certainly flown by for me. I truly enjoy and love my job, and I get great satisfaction from serving the citizens of Forsyth County. I was fortunate to inherit a great staff from my predecessor, and I believe the staff of the Forsyth County Clerk's Office is without equal in the state. They've stuck together in our present economic downturn without complaint. Their hard work has allowed me to operate a lean office and reduce our budget to the bare minimum for efficiently operating the clerk's office. We found workarounds to reduce our cramped and outdated office space that we must utilize out of our 1970s era courthouse, trailers, the basement of an old furniture store, and rented space at a private business. The employees' acceptance and embrace of technologies and changes in operations have allowed us to serve a growing population of citizens and a growing number of cases and transactions with fewer employees in 2012, which is 31, than the office employed in 2006, which that time office had 36 employees. A lot of people don't know what the Clerk of Superior Court actually does. I'll fill you in a bit on that. The Clerk of Superior Court is established in the Constitution of the state of Georgia. The clerk is one of four constitutional officers found in each of the 159 counties in the state. The tax commissioner and the probate judge are two of the others, and the fourth constitutional officer is the sheriff. The Superior Court was established in 1798, and it's the highest state trial court, the highest court in each circuit. It is a court of record, and that means all records, documentation, and minutes filed in the court cannot be altered after their filing. The clerk's elected by the voters every 4 years, and I'm responsible for maintaining court records for both superior and state courts in this county. That includes all your criminal cases, criminal warrants, civil cases, divorces, adoptions, name changes, habeas corpus cases, and suits for damages and garnishments. Additionally, the clerk records all of your real estate transactions, such as warranty deeds, quit claim deeds, security deeds, assignments, right-of-way deeds, easements, and property plats. In addition, my office is also responsible for recording FIFAs, military discharges, trade names, the Uniform Commercial Code filings, property transfer taxes. And lastly, the clerk's office also issues notary public appointments, maintains and manages the jury system, and assists the general public with obtaining the various court and real estate records. As additionally serving as your state court clerk, I'm also in charge of the Traffic Violations Bureau and collect all fines and assessments regarding state court, which includes all your misdemeanors and traffic tickets. During 2011, the General Assembly assigned the Clerk of Superior Court with the duties of providing administrative support to the Board of Equalization, and that was previously under the Tax Assessor's Office. So the duties are many and varied, which was what makes the office so enjoyable. Again, I have wonderful employees that allow me to make a lot of changes. We've had a lot of technology changes, a lot of updates that allow us to have a more efficient office for the public. I plan on continuing to do that. We're going to very soon go online with accepting traffic payments online, and we're also going to be having the ability to look up your court cases online. Real estate's been online since I took office. We have a website that gives you all of your jury information and updates and all the basic information on the clerk's office, so you don't have to try to look at that up on your own or call our office to get information. And again, thank you very much for allowing me to serve as your clerk for the last 4 years, and I'm looking forward to serving the next 4 years for you. Thank you.
Thank you. Well, I unfortunately just got a text from our Solicitor General, and she was planning on being here, Leslie Abernathy, and told me that she was taken ill and won't be able to join us. So, our last candidate who will be speaking tonight is our probate judge, Lynwood Jordan. We have the pleasure, as we say, if you've seen, we have some really impressive folks who are doing great things in office. But Judge Jordan has actually served as the chair of the state probate judges association. So we have some very impressive folks who are running our administrative offices here in the county, and I'm pleased to introduce Judge Lynwood Jordan.
Thank you, Mr. Underwood. As everyone else has said, I must thank the citizens of Forsyth County for giving me the opportunity to serve as their probate judge. And it's a position which is, as time goes on, is becoming more and more important. We are entering an era which is going to perhaps, well not perhaps, I think it's a certainty, have the greatest wealth transfer, intergenerational wealth transfer that's ever occurred in the history of the United States with the baby boom generation and their parents transferring wealth to them. Also, the demographics of our population indicates, and this is occurring here, that the incidences of adult guardianships and conservatorships will be increasing. That's happening. And of course, as time goes on, the incidence of decedents' estates will also increase. I take seriously the responsibilities of preparing for these challenges, which the citizens of Forsyth County have entrusted to me. And there are several points I'd like to make real quickly here. One area that we've been concentrating over the years is speedy resolution of cases. In many cases that are filed in our court, and by the way, Mr. Ledbetter, we answer the phones live also. Thought I'd mention that. I think Mr. Allen does too, but anyway, call him sometimes, see if you can get it. But anyway, speedy resolution of disputes is critical for some of these cases, and there are many, many actions that are filed that require no further action in probate court where I'll enter an order within hours after them being filed. My staff has been told that they need to move these things. Average probably be 2 or 3 days. I was going to run the numbers, but I didn't get a chance to. The other area which we pride ourselves on are speedy resolution of jury trials. We don't have that many, but when we have them, they're important to people because they're usually in the area of decedents' estates, and you have somebody that's missing, and business needs to be taken care of. Last week, I had a jury trial that began on Monday morning, and we finished it about noon on Friday. And that case had only been filed for a year. And after the attorneys did their 6 months discovery, we pushed it on and had a jury trial and got it taken care of. That has an additional benefit to the citizens of Forsyth County that may not be readily apparent, and that is that freed up a superior court judge for a week. Normally those cases used to be handled by a superior court, so by the probate court handling those cases now, it enables a superior court judge to have a complete week to which that judge would have normally been trying this case to handle other business in the Superior Court. The strengthening of the Probate Judges Council is something I've been able to do, as Mr. Underwood mentioned, with my presidency of the Probate Judges Council of Georgia. That has benefits for the citizens of Forsyth County also. There are several areas I serve in, like the Institute of Continuing Judicial Education. I'm on the Board of Trustees for that. That's the area that teaches all of the judges in the state. So I get to participate a lot in preparing materials for the judges to be presented to teach clerks. That's coming up in another couple of weeks down south of Atlanta. And I bring all this back with me. You'd be amazed how much preparation of educational materials helps you. You learn what you don't know, and then you learn it because you got to teach somebody else. And that, even though that's, you know, outside of the county, it benefits us. Each one of the administrators or executors in our county gets a booklet that has a map and instructions of what you do as a personal representative of a decedent's estate. And that is published by the council. It's distributed by the administrative office of the courts. We wrote that, but all of our citizens benefit from it, because each time somebody is appointed in my court, they receive a copy of this book. So even though we are doing statewide things, our own citizens benefit from it, and that makes it worthwhile. Believe me, it does. And of course, you know from the recent stories that I've been involved also in statewide legislation, that also benefits our citizens. I'm going to continue these efforts. We've got a meeting on the 29th of this month to get ready for a program in November to teach all of the new judges that are elected in the state of Georgia for a week-long program over in Athens, and we're completely revamping that. That kind of a effort, as I said earlier, keeps you up to date on everything that's going on and keeps you sharp. At my age, you need something like that to keep going. But anyway, it's a very rewarding thing. There's one other thing as far as plans for the future that I've been thinking about doing, and I think I'm going to start this off within the next 4 months or so. I have been considering for a year or two starting a public information campaign for the citizens here in Forsyth County to make some more information available to them, both in print and in electronic format, whether it's ebooks or on the internet through a special internet site. And I think I'm going to do that pretty soon, to give them information about guardianships, conservatorships, what you do within the state, how do you plan ahead of time, what you need to do about powers of attorney, how do you avoid these pitfalls that people suddenly find themselves involved in as they get older, or as things happen like automobile accidents and so forth. There was a special federal grant where I and another judge taught some attorneys on some of these things, and I see no reason. These are attorneys that didn't know anything about this area of practice, and we were teaching them how they could do the basics, and in exchange, the federal grant required them to give free legal service to some senior citizens for a certain amount of time. And so we have that material already presented, and you think, well, if why not give it to the members of the public too, so they can learn what they need to do and what to look out for. Of course, all through this, it's going to emphasize the fact that legal advice from an attorney is very, very, very much desirable in this area. But I think that's what I'm going to do in the next few months or year, and perhaps that will enable me to impart some of this information that I've gathered over the years to the citizens of Forsyth County, and hopefully that will enable them to plan better and cut down on the court cases, either guardianships, conservatorships, or contested estate matters like we had last week. Thank you very much.
I'm all right for that. Well,
we appreciate y'all coming out. I hope that this has demonstrated to you that we have some of the most talented officials in the state of Georgia working on these administrative matters for the citizens of Forsyth County. They need your support, and certainly they welcome any of your comments or recommendations of how they can do their jobs better. So thank you all for coming out. We do want to remind everyone that tomorrow night we have our debates. It will be the first of our series of with contested offices. Our county commission debates will be tomorrow night at 6:30 here at the board commissioner's room. We'll be starting at 6:30 with the District 5 candidates. At 7:30, the debate will be for the District 4 candidates. And at 8:30, the debates for the District 2 candidates. So I hope that you will bring all your friends, learn more about these candidates, as we've got very important decisions And these folks will be serving for the next 4 years, so we need to make sure we get the right person who's carrying the banner for the Republican Party. Thank you very much for coming. We look forward to seeing you tomorrow night. Thank you, sir, for coming. I appreciate it.
Thanks, boy.
He was well
behaved. So I got a sucker out of it. That's the best part.
That's the best part.
Mr. Tisdale, I thank you for filming. It helps get more information out, so we appreciate it.
You're very welcome.